Hello, hello, good evening, everyone. Welcome back.
Hello, good evening, teacher.
Hello.
Hello.
Good evening.
Good evening, good evening. Hello, Sarai, how are you?
Hello.
Good to see you.
Excellent.
Good to see you again.
Hello,
and I ask
you. Hello. Estamos. Estamos vivas todavía.
Yeah. Thanks God. Thanks God. Gracias a Dios. All right. So welcome everyone. I have here some new faces. Right. Tengo caritas nuevas por acá. Okay. So I have Susana. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I also have Zulma. Nice to meet you over there.
Oh. Hi, good evening.
So I have Mr. Baltasar. How are you, sir?
Teacher.
How are
Thank you,
sir? You. Yeah, are welcome, you? Welcome, sir. And I have welcome, over sir. Here a tocayo, right? So I have Nick, say, Francisco Rodriguez, Mr. Rodriguez in there. Mr. Douglas, hello, sir. I also have
How are you?
Catherine over too, right? Hello, Catherine. Welcome aboard, right?
Hello, thank you.
Yeah, welcome back. You know, good to have you everyone over here. So far I have, let's see, 10 participants, which is a good number in there. So, Mr. Rodrigo, so welcome back. Ms. Dalia Margarita, so welcome aboard. And let's say, creo que ya los llamé a todos over here, so I call you everyone. Yes, Ms. Dalia, you wanna say something?
Hello, teacher.
Hello. All right, so let's begin then, everyone. So here we go. Just one second, Molly. Okay, one second. All right, so I'm going to start with the Spanish right now. Gran sorpresa que me llevé cuando me asignaron el grupo y yo dije... Me asignaron otro grupo porque el anterior, si ustedes se fijaron, era el G7 y algo, ¿verdad? Más o menos así. Y este es el G10. Es el G10, ese es el código ese. Entonces yo dije, no, entonces no son ellos, ¿verdad? Pero luego revisé cuando me mandaron la lista de asistencia y dije, ah, aquí está. Quiero ver a Nayansi. Le habían escrito mal el nombre, por cierto, fíjese, Nayansi. Se lo habían puesto con S y con I. El suyo es con C e Y, right? Entonces, igual, y, ah, ok. So I have Mr. Cesar over there, and I have Rocío, Miss Pimentel. Welcome back. Cesar.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, sir. Eduardo, I have you again over here, sir. Nice. Nice seeing you. Seeing you over there. Okay. So, all right, so since this is just module two of beginner, I think I should start speaking to you a little bit more of English, okay? So, and I think that should be better for you. Let me just one second over here. All right, so I was telling you, since this is a new module, okay, and this is beginner module two, I will start speaking to you a little bit more of English. Let's say we're going to go like 70% English and then let's say 30% of Spanish. So, and that has to be the deal. Of course, if you want me to say something again, si quieren que yo le repita, say again, please. Can you say that again, please? Or start over, please. One more time, please. Or, you know, something like that. Okay. Es decir, que en lugar de hablarles más español, les voy a ir incrementando un poquito más el inglés, ¿verdad? Es lo que les estoy mencionando. Mr. Raúl, welcome aboard, sir. Yeah, you didn't hear me, I can't see. So, Mr. Raúl, sir, welcome aboard. Yeah, nice to see you, honestly speaking, everyone. Yes. Okay, so 15 participants. So, let me share the screen with you. And then we take it from there. So just one second. Here we go. Okay. One second. La última clase fue bien maratónica, me recuerdo. Entonces les agradezco mucho que se quedaron. Y si tenían que irse porque tenían que trabajar y tenían otros compromisos igual. De todo corazón les doy las gracias por haberse quedado. Este módulo va a ser un poquito más intenso. Espero que nos acompañen siempre en todas las clases y si no, por lo menos en el 80%. Si usted es nuevo en el programa de inglés para el trabajo, este es el momento para que usted me haga preguntas o levante la mano. Así explico yo generalidades o si no en el camino vemos esas cosas porque estamos acá para practicar, ¿verdad? Para aprender, distraernos un poco de las rutinas diarias. Entonces, de eso se trata. Permítame un momento. Ok. Quería mostrarle lo siguiente. Un poquito de generalidades. Vamos a ver. Aquí está. El módulo va desde este día, que es el Monday, March the 1st. And the last day of class is Friday, March 26th. Primero Dios. We will be together for 4 weeks. And that means that the last day for you to do all assignments in the Inglés Corporativo platform is March the 26th. Esta fecha es muy importante. Vamos desde el primero, que es este día, hasta el viernes 26 de marzo. Ok. Esperemos primero Dios que, que no tengamos ningún problema de conexión, que se graben todas las clases. ¿Verdad? Si usted tiene alguna duda con lo de la plataforma, yo sé que eso es, como les dije la vez pasada, it's a piece of cake, right? O sea, va a ser fácil para ustedes completar la plataforma. En esta clase, si usted es nuevo para el inglés corporativo, hacemos esta clase participativa, comunicativa, y yo me atrevería a decir de una forma colaborativa, ¿verdad? Si se fijan, en el sentido de que los mando a los salones reducidos, ustedes practican conversaciones, practican ejercicios y luego reforzamos en las salas generales. ¿Ok? Entonces yo ahí sí cumplo el rol de facilitador. ¿Ok? Voy a ir incrementando el nivel de inglés que les voy a ir hablando. Si es posible, les hablo solamente en inglés. Obviamente pausado de una forma que ustedes puedan seguirme. Porque al final se trata, ¿verdad? De ir aumentando ese vocabulario. Aunque usted no pueda decir la palabra, pero por lo menos va a entender el contexto de lo que yo le estoy diciendo. ¿Ok? Entonces, y cuando usted menos se dé cuenta, ya va a poder entender una conversación por lo menos básica o de un nivel intermedio en inglés. ¿Ok? Y yo le aseguro que las prácticas que hacemos en clase son más difíciles que lo que se le pide en la plataforma. Y los que estuvieron conmigo el mes pasado, no me van a dejar mentir, que quizás las clases, los ejercicios son un poquito más difíciles lo que hacemos acá. Pronunciación, gramática, ejercicios de complemento, variados, ¿verdad? Entonces, lo que se hace en la plataforma es solamente práctica adicional, que es un requisito para que usted apruebe el módulo. Solamente tres recordatorios. 80% de asistencia. De mi parte, el 100%, ¿verdad? Espero que ustedes participen en cada clase. Es decir, que son 5 por 4, son 20 clases, si no me equivoco. Se les pide el 80% de asistencia en la plataforma, el 80% de aprobación. La gran mayoría sacó 95%, 100% en la plataforma. Y lo último que se hace el día de clases, y se espera que se haga con el facilitador, en el caso soy yo, es la encuesta, ¿verdad? De... ¿Cómo es que se llamaba esa encuesta? Se me olvida el nombre, ¿verdad? Pero es una encuesta para ver si cómo se...
De satisfacción.
Satisfacción, yes. Satisfaction survey, thank you. La encuesta de satisfacción que se hace en clases el último día, ¿ok? Entonces, y cada miércoles tenemos el apoyo del 101 para que ustedes, como somos 20 participantes, cada miércoles tienen la oportunidad de estar 10 minutos conmigo después de las 10 de la noche. Se va a mandar la lista de quiénes van a estar, entonces, y si usted no puede, puede rotarse, y pues, como yo les digo, se puede reenganchar, es decir, puede otra vez usted participar, ¿ok? Son generalidades. So, that being said, let's begin, all right? So, last day of class is March the 26th, and today is March the 1st, or is the first day of class, which we have today. Okay, so, if you want, you can take notes. Remember that these... manual is already available for you. If you want me, I can share with you a copy of this manual. Yo les puedo compartir una copia de ese manual si no lo tienen todavía. And in class, whatever I have to share with you, like images, exercises, or anything that I share with you, I do it through WhatsApp, all right? So, una cosa que les iba a decir y que les iba a recomendar, si usted todavía no está en el grupo de WhatsApp, ¿verdad? Al que, perdón, tiene que ingresar por invitación. Y voy a compartir mi pantalla. Creo que alcanzan a ver mi pantalla. Solo un par de minutos, 8 y 15, comenzamos en punto con las prácticas y lo que se trata, lo que ustedes han venido. Si usted no está en... Perdón. Voy a compartirles esto. Voy a mandar este enlace de WhatsApp por si ustedes no están en el grupo de WhatsApp y lo voy a compartir en el chat de Zoom en estos instantes. Ok. Si tienen alguna duda acerca de las generalidades, de cómo funciona el sistema de evaluación, las clases o algo que usted quisiera hablar conmigo, este es el mejor momento para hacer eso. Ok. Aquí está. Ok. Va a necesitar estar usted en el grupo de WhatsApp, ¿verdad? Para esta noche y para las siguientes 19 clases que vamos a tener juntos, primero Dios. Entonces, para que usted sea parte de la práctica que vamos a tener en la noche, ¿verdad? Si no está en el grupo. Ok. All right, so I don't have anything else to tell you over here, but just to begin with this. Ok. So, hold on. Okay. Mr. Baltazar, solo confírmeme si alcanza a ver la pantalla que les estoy compartiendo de la plataforma.
Sí, teacher, yes.
Okay, so thank you, sir. So let me just go very quickly to see what you guys are going to be working in this class. So for this first unit, okay, and let me go here, instructor. Vamos a ir aquí rápido al student admin, ¿verdad? permítanme un momento. Gradebook. Okay. Progress. Aquí estamos. solamente para una recapitulación, ¿verdad? Para las personas que son nuevas para el inglés corporativo, no tengo ese dato, por eso estoy haciendo esto, ¿verdad? Entonces me van a disculpar. Téngame un poquito de paciencia si usted ya sabe esto, pero creo que no está de más. So, in total, you have to complete 4, let's see, macro homework assignments, ¿verdad? Macro, tareas macros. And each week, you have to complete, let's say, 5 activities, I would say, or 5 short exercises, which are multiple choice. Cada asignación macro, que es prácticamente una unidad, usted se divide en 5 ejercicios cortos, ¿ok? Para que usted complete la homework number one, tiene que tener estas 5 actividades completas que le va a dar el 20%. Y así sucesivamente. Section 2, Unit 2, Ongoing Activities at the Workplace, igual le va a dar 5 actividades, complételas al 100%. No solamente porque es el 80% de aprobación, lo va a dejar así, ¿verdad? Yo sé que ustedes lo hacen, van más allá. El viernes usted puede completar si gusta la plataforma de una sola vez, ¿verdad? Si es posible, ya mañana la tiene lista. Si usted maneja los contenidos, esta semana, por ejemplo, es repaso del Simple Present, ¿ok? Simple Present que utilizamos para hábitos, rutinas, etc. Entonces, si usted se siente en la capacidad de completar Unit 1 Work Related Events, go ahead and do it. Si por casualidad no puntea al 100%, no se preocupe, ¿verdad? Lo importante es empezar a foguearse, ¿ok? Si usted lleva las cosas de una forma un poco más, no sé, planificadas o dosificadas, en teoría, clase dada, actividad realizada, ¿verdad? Digamos, day number one, activity one. Day number two, activity two. Day number three, activity three, and so on, right? Etcétera, etcétera, ¿ok? Lo que vamos a hacer es, cuando se llegue el viernes, porque a mí me piden actualizar notas el día viernes, si usted ya hizo el ejercicio o ya completó parcial o completamente la plataforma, section 1 o la tarea que corresponde van a ser las primeras 5 actividades de la unidad 1. Repito, unidad 1 se vence el día viernes. No hemos comenzado clase, ya le estoy dejando tarea. Ok. Comparten en el chat de WhatsApp y eso se los pido como un favor adicional para que nos motivemos, ya sea que usted me lo comparte de forma privada o lo pone en el chat general. Así yo, sus compañeros por lo menos se van a recordar y van a hacer clic, hay que hacer tarea. Y yo también llevo récord y saco la lista de, ok, falta Mr. Raúl Meléndez, ya la hizo, entonces ya le pongo un checkmark y llevo un control interno, ¿verdad? Entonces, para apoyarles un poco. Okay, porque de eso se trata. So I don't have anything else to tell you about this, but there is, okay, 4 sections, 1 midterm exam, que es el parcial, y el and the final exam. Obviamente el midterm y el and the final exam valen 25% cada uno, y si usted hace la matemática, si usted hace el parcial y hace el examen final, ahí ya tiene 5 de nota. Le faltarían 3 puntos para llegar al 80%. Si usted es como calculador. Pero como va a dar el 100% y más, va a decir, ok, hago las 4 tareas, hago el midterm, y ya con eso tengo casi la nota de aprobación. Entonces, yo me pongo las pilas para hacer el section 4. ¿Ok? Esa es la lógica, ¿verdad? Que yo tengo con esto. All right. Let's see, Mr. Meléndez. Now, could you please confirm if you're able to see the name of the units, the one that says map of the book. Do you see that? The PDF. Yes. Okay, thank you, sir. So just so you know on this one, so take a look. On unit 1, it means that this whole week, esta semana completa, we will talk about the following, okay? And this is what you will be able to. Entonces usted tiene que ser capaz de describe regular activities in the workplace. Describe everyday situations. Identify requests, que son solicitudes o peticiones. for specific personal finance information. Talk about financial information and work perks, como actividades, beneficios. Scan specific information fields in an informative document. And the vocabulary, of course, check my email, type a letter, write a report, attend a meeting, time expressions. So this unit, you're going to learn adverbs of frequency, like always, sometimes, often, et cetera, et cetera. Okay. So in time expressions, like monthly, every year, every week, every day, every weekend, etc. And then you also will learn how to say how much, que es cuánto, and how many, which is cuánto también. How much and how many significa lo mismo, solamente que la gramática is the one that changes over. Okay, so that's on this unit number one, right? So, and then solamente les recuerdo que ustedes tienen acceso a este documento y cuando ustedes estimen conveniente pueden accesar. Este mismo documento está en la plataforma y si no me equivoco, está aquí donde dice Students Manual P2. Aquí pueden accesar ustedes. Les recomiendo que lo descarguen y si ustedes me dicen, José, send it to me, please, and share it through WhatsApp, go ahead and do it. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do it, all right? Sorry about the dog barking, you know, in front of my notebooks. In there. So as you can see, this manual has conversations and everything. And then it has exercises. In this module, we will be using this. We'll be combining. Vamos a estar combinando este PDF que nos da INSAFOR y vamos a estar combinando los ejercicios que yo les tengo como conversaciones y los otros que están con otro color. Entonces, so that's what we will be doing, right? So it will be a combination of this document. Entonces, por eso les pido que lo tengan. Así yo no les mando imágenes, sino que usted tiene el PDF o si no se lo mando después de terminar la clase. So in every single class, we will be using this PDF, okay? And the exercises that I shared with you over here, okay? Plus some other details that I'll be sharing with you. Una modalidad que a mí me gusta implementar es para apoyarles en el vocabulario es that word of the night. All right? But since this is module 2, les voy a apoyar no solamente con una palabra, with a word, but with a phrase. Como es nivel 2, it's level 2, we will start with the word of the night. Yo les prometo que cada clase vamos a dedicarnos unos 5 minutos para aprendernos vocabulario. Y no necesariamente usted se lo va a aprender en el momento, pero por lo menos puede hacer una lista. Y I remember like 2 weeks ago speaking to Miss Pimentel and then she had a vocabulary, a notebook, right? Tiene un cuaderno, una libreta con un montón de vocabulario, ¿verdad? Con mucho vocabulario. I remember that. So and in this opportunity, I'll be sharing with you vocabulary. But in this case, it'll be phrases. En este caso, yo le voy a compartir frases. Okay. And let's pay attention to the following, ¿verdad? Si tienen alguna consulta, la pueden hacer en este momento. He invertido 20, 22 minutos en darle generalidades, ¿verdad? But I promise, this is the only time I'll be giving you, explaining how the system works. Okay. So, the word or phrase of the evening or the night is cost an arm and a leg. Who can give me a translation of that phrase? Cost an arm and a leg. ¿Quién me ayuda con una traducción? No literal, ¿verdad? Pero más que todo, un poquito más pensada. Of the meaning of cost an arm and a leg. All right. Somebody over here? Do you have any idea what cost an arm and a leg might mean? ¿Verdad? What I mean is, si usted traduce esta frase, no sé, literalmente, ¿cómo la traduciría? Somebody over here, please, a volunteer who can actually help me out.
Es una frase similar a me cuesta un ojo de la cara.
Exactly.
Así lo entiendo.
Exactly, you got it. Thank you, Miss Pimentel. You got it. Actually, that's the meaning, right? Cost an arm and a leg. In English, you say, for example, what costs an arm and a leg? When something costs an arm and a leg, it's very expensive. Notice the following. Cuando es algo muy caro, muy costoso, you say, housing these days costs an arm and a leg. Or college cost me an arm and a leg. All right? Le cuesta un ojo de la cara, pues, comprar una casa, ¿verdad? Con el fondo o con el banco, right? So that's expensive. We know that, right? And I can give you an example. Having a car accident costs an arm and a leg, ¿verdad? Accidentarse, ¿verdad? Crash a car or crash a motorcycle. So that costs an arm and a leg. All right, that, trust me, I've been there, right? Minimum crashes, but I've been there. So like the university, and you can tell, how do you say colegios in English, right? How do you say colegios? Where your children go to school? How do you say colegios? Anybody here? So how do you say colegios? All right, so we say, escuela, we say school, right? Si es escuela pública, we say public school, right? So how do you say colegio? The thing is that I want to make a point in here, right? So I want to tell you the difference between college, which is, let's see, a small university with colegios, ¿verdad? Nosotros decimos colegios privados, pero by definition, un colegio es una institución privada, right? But in English, how do we say colegio, right? Because I'm asking you, because in this class, you're going to introduce yourself. And let's see, this evening, you will talk about somebody else, maybe your son, your daughter, your wife, husband, and about yourself. Entonces, en esta clase, esta noche, usted va a hablar acerca de una tercera persona y acerca de usted. Okay. So, should I ask? O les pregunto. Yes, Foro. Thank you. Good to see you, by the way.
Es a facultad o algo así.
No, lo que les estoy diciendo acá solo para aclarar, college es una universidad, ¿verdad? Pero es un poquito más pequeño. Lo que yo quiero aclarar es colegio, donde usted manda a sus niños, ¿verdad? A estudiar y que es privado, obviamente, no se dice college, ¿ok? No se dice college, para que no nos confundamos. Entonces, yo quisiera saber si ustedes conocen el término en inglés. O sea, ese es mi punto ahorita. If you don't know it, I mean, that's okay. So no problem. I'm going to share it with you. Si no lo conocen, yo se los comparto. No? Maybe Cesar. Eduardo, do you have the term in there? Juan Carlos. Susana, anybody? No?
High school? No.
High school. I mean, yeah, high school is just bachillerato, right? Which is something, you know, before the university. You know, the levels within school, you have kindergarten, you have primary school, middle school, or junior school, and then you have high school, ¿verdad? Pero esos son los ciclos, ¿verdad? Primer ciclo, segundo, tercero, etc. Right? But that's something else. Si la escuela es pública, ¿verdad? It's public school. Si usted manda a alguien a un colegio, it's private school. And that's how you say it. All right? Private school. Okay? Si se escribe private, right? Private, okay? Private school, that's how you say it. So don't say, please, my daughter or my son or my children go to, no sé, Itexal College. If you say college, that's incorrect, ¿verdad? College es universidad. Entonces, es colegio privado, es private school, all right? So let's continue with this, right? We will start with a review about the simple present over here, right? We will start with a review about the simple present in here. Pero lo vamos a hacer de una forma deductiva, okay? O sea, si ustedes van a deducir las reglas de la tercera persona en el siguiente ejercicio que les voy a mandar, okay? And let me share the screen with you. Allow me just one second over here. ¿Verdad? Recuérdese, como estamos en nivel 2, O sea, no es que ustedes sean masters, ¿verdad? Pero creo que hemos aprendido y hemos aprendido bien, ¿verdad? Por su, because of your perseverance, right? Por su perseverancia, right? So, I'll be sharing with you the following over here. Okay. Y en estos momentos yo se los voy a, les voy a enviar el documento. Yo sé que no estoy compartiendo pantalla. No se preocupen, ténganme paciencia. And then we take it from there. Do you have any questions, by the way, you know, for me about the platform, about grades, acerca de sus notas, grades, etc., etc.? All right. Or, so is everything clear right now? Les pregunto porque ahorita no los estoy viendo en la pantalla, entonces, porque les estoy compartiendo un documento. Si todavía no está en WhatsApp, este es el momento indicado para que usted ingrese a WhatsApp. Ok. Y comenzamos a practicar de una sola vez. Y si me dice, no sé cómo ingresar, yo le ayudo con mucho gusto. Ok, pero si todo está bien, practiquemos, que a eso hemos venido. And here we go.
Private school.
Okay.
Private school.
Here we go. All right. Ahí está, ya miro que ingresaron varios. I'm sending, you know, the spelling of private school over there. Siéntase en la libertad de decirme, ¿cómo lo deletreo? How do you spell private school? ¿Verdad? Si a mí se me va, I can, you know, share it with you. All right? Private school. Okay. I send the phrase to both Zoom and also to the chat on WhatsApp over there. So now, I'm attaching the a PDF, which is going to have like 2 or 3 or 4 pages in there, okay? En este momento les estoy compartiendo un PDF que va a tener como 3 o 4 páginas, okay? So allow me just 1 second over here. All right. Y perdone que estamos un poquito lentos por ahí, ¿verdad? Pero el primer día creo que es así un poquito, pero ya nos vamos a desquitar, ya vamos a aprovechar un poco. Okay. Present Simple Daily Routines, and that's the name of the document that I just sent to you. Así se llama el documento que les acaba de mandar, ¿verdad? Daily Routines, and I think I'm getting it right now. Yes, it has 4 pages. La tecnología es tan bonita, ¿verdad? Que nos permite ver ese documento. All right, so can somebody just please confirm with me if you actually got the document and if you can open it. ¿Se puede abrir? ¿Tienen acceso? ¿Funciona? ¿Working? Yep.
Yeah.
Nice. All right, thank you, sir. So here we go, everyone. So please, I want you to scroll up and down page 1, page 2, and page 3, as you can see in here. Okay, and then we have 2 people. We have Mr. Miller, and then we have Miss Lucy, all right? Miss Lucy, and then we have Mr. Miller in there. It says, interview, read aloud and listen activity. Your name is Mr. Miller. A TV news reporter just asked you to tell him about your daily routine. Read aloud your answer. I'm sorry, so it says, please tell me about your daily routine. So you have 2 people in here. So you have Mr. Miller, and then you have Mr. Lucy. Like for example, if I have 2 of you, and this is your information in there. Remember, you don't have to memorize anything out of this one. No se tiene que memorizar nada. What you have to do is you have to read the information aloud in here, okay? Entonces, para comenzar a practicar, ¿verdad? Y a desenredar un poquito la lengua a esta noche después de una semana de vacación, vamos a hacer lo siguiente. In groups of 3, okay, you will be practicing Mr. Miller and Mr. Lucy's information over there, okay? Usted decide si usted es Mr. Miller or if you are Miss Lucy in there. So the first thing, the first time you practice in the breakout rooms, it will be just reading, right? Reading, solamente vamos a darle lectura a los dos párrafos. All right? For example, let's say, Francisco, you can be Mr. Miller, and then Flor, you can be Miss Lucy Miller. And that's it. All right? So that's what you're going to do. Les dije que va a ser de una forma... van a deducir, ¿verdad? Esto. Because in the third page, you're going to have questions in there about Mr. Miller and about Miss Lucy. All right? Then, once you're done with the practice, I'm going to ask you questions. Yo le voy a preguntar, ¿verdad? En general. So, what is... Le voy a hacer las mismas preguntas over here, pero se las voy a hacer in real time. Significa así como estamos ahorita, todos practicando. I'm going to ask you those questions. Y usted lo que va a hacer es ir a escanear el documento and give me the response. Okay? All right, so that's going to be the first thing que vamos a hacer. Okay. But first of all, let me go ahead and help you with the pronunciation over here. Pero como aquí ustedes son los protagonistas, can I please have a volunteer, please, who can help me read, let's say, the first paragraph, hasta aquí donde lo estoy highlighting, over there. Okay. Prefiero mejor darles el feedback de que alguien que me ayude a leer, que yo solamente hablar en inglés, ¿verdad? Porque la cuestión es que usted practique. So, can I have a volunteer, please, only one volunteer, either a gentleman. Thank you, Juan Carlos. You're going to be the first one over here. All right? Remember, you don't have to memorize anything. Go ahead, please, Juan Carlos.
I am an English teacher and I have a big family. So I have a very busy daily routine. First, I get up every day at 6 o'clock. Washed and dressed and life or work by 7:30. I get to school at 8 o'clock. I prepare my lesson and then teach until noon. The other teacher and I always eat lunch and talk together in the teacher's room. I teach again in the afternoon and then I correct my students' homework and test. After I get back home, I help my kids with their homework. I have 3 kids in elementary school. Their names are Matthew, John, and Susie. Then I do some exercise, eat dinner with my family, and watch TV before I go to bed at about 10 o'clock. We love to watch travel shows. Finally, I read in bed for a few minutes before I fell asleep.
All right, thank you so much, sir. I appreciate your help over there. So take a look at this at my screen, all right? So as you can see, this is an English teacher, and then he goes with, all right, adverbs of frequency. Si usted mira, el first, okay, if you have then, after, then again, right? Tal vez si me ayuda a identificar adverbs of sequence, adverbios de secuencia, ¿verdad? O connectors in that reading. Remember that you have the PDF. Ya tienen el documento, ¿verdad? Si está en WhatsApp. Ahí está, okay? So you have it there. Vamos a comenzar con eso, ¿verdad? And the first thing I need to tell you in this class is, whenever you talk about your routines, you need to start with a short introduction, let's say. And what's your intro? It's the adverb of sequence or a connector. Tiene que ser un conector, ¿verdad? You have to start first, second, third, then, after that, in the afternoon, at 4 o'clock, in the evening, at 8 p.m., etc., etc. In that way, you will have a logical routine in your mind, okay? Or you can say around, at about, etc. So, si no somos así como, like, very specific, or you don't go by the book, right? O sea, no es así como, sigue la regla, que, like, for example, you have dinner at 6 p.m. Sometimes you have dinner at 6:30 or sometimes you don't have dinner, all right? Entonces, son reglas que ustedes pueden omitir, ¿verdad? Palabras que pueden omitir. Entonces, the first advice that I can give you this evening is, comencemos con adverbios de secuencia o conectores cuando usted presente algo, all right? So that's the first, I would say, lesson that I want to share with you. Comencemos con esas palabritas, ¿verdad? So, for example, it says, now, acordémonos de los conectores. Una práctica más que vamos a retomar en estas clases son link sounds, ¿verdad? Se acordaba, it says, Professor, I see a URL when you later. Yeah, you're right. Thank you, Cesar. Yeah, thank you, Cesar. Yeah, but in this case, I double check and I think it's okay. Take a look. Pero, okay. Una cosa más que se me olvidaba compartirles, ¿verdad? Cuando ustedes vayan a una página web, les recomiendo, ¿verdad? Y se los pido que borremos la URL, ¿verdad? O el link de donde sacamos la información. En este caso, gracias César por recordarme. No es necesario borrarlo mucho, pero nosotros desconfiamos de todo, ¿verdad? Entonces, aquí ya me dieron permiso. Dice, permission granted to reproduce for classroom use. Entonces me dice, permisos han sido dados para reproducción en clase, ¿verdad? Entonces, pero no nos arriesgamos mucho. Así que gracias por haberme recordado, César. Pero en esto sí tenemos, digamos, yo tengo la seguridad que no nos van a bajar el canal. Ok. That being said, acordémonos. I need to ask you. So, Eduardo, do you remember what a link sound is, sir? A link sound, sir. By any chance. A link sound.
Yeah, yep. The way you say two words, like sounds like it's going to be
correct.
Like one word.
Exactly. So, sometimes you complain that United States citizens, you see, you complain that Americans speak way too fast, right? They speak fast like if somebody is like chasing them, como si se los están persiguiendo, la gente habla, ¿verdad? Y eso se debe a los link sounds. And as I told you, let's say last month, les dije el mes pasado, y eso lo reforcé bastante, es unan las consonantes con las vocales. En este caso sería I'm an English teacher, ¿verdad? Aquí vamos, I'm an English teacher, and I have a big family, so I have a very busy daily routine. First, I get up. En inglés, la T casi siempre se hace una R, ¿ok? Listen to that, please. All right? La T casi siempre se hace una R, ¿verdad? Y eso es casi siempre cuando va al final de la palabra. So first, I get up every day at 6 o'clock, get washed. En este caso, mejor no me pronuncie la ed, mejor diga el verbo tal cual es, porque no hemos visto todavía el pasado, pero si lo quiere decir como en realidad es, va a decir get dressed, get washed, o si no lo dice, get washed, then get dressed, and leave for work by 7:30. I get to school. Y cuando tengan dos T's unidas, como en este caso, ¿verdad? Está la T de get, está la T de to, solamente mencione la segunda T, ¿ok? You say, I get to school, ¿verdad? Yo llego a la escuela, ¿all right? Yo llego a la escuela. I get to school at 8 o'clock. I prepare my lessons and then teach until noon. Antes significa hasta. The other teachers, esta palabra que significa el, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, el volado que decimos nosotros en español, o la cosa, esto. Si comienza la siguiente palabra en sonido de vocal, puede decirle usted the other, all right? The apple, all right? So, the other teachers and I always eat lunch and talk together in the teacher's room. I teach again. Right. Si se fija, uno yo, el sonido de la CH con again, right? I teach again in the afternoon and then I correct my students' homework and test. Recuérdese que tareas, la palabra homework, never takes an S. Nunca se le escribe una S a la palabra homework. Usted puede decir, I have two homework assignments. assignments o asignaciones, sí le puede poner la S. Okay? And that's actually mandatory. After I get back home, I help my kids with their homework, and I have three kids in elementary school. Their names are Matthew, John, and Susie. Then I do some exercise, eat dinner with my family, and watch TV. Before I go to bed at about 10 o'clock. We love to watch travel shows. Finally, I read in bed for a few minutes before I fall asleep. Quedarse dormido se dice fall asleep. Yo le puedo preguntar, what time do you fall asleep? Right, asleep. Si se fija, esto no es el verbo dormirse, sino que es el estado de estar dormido, right? Asleep, all right? Okay. So, let's take a look at this one, everyone. Now we have Miss Lucy, all right? We have Miss Lucy. Can somebody help me with Miss Lucy over here? Okay, Miss Lucy over here. Lady, si alguien nos ayuda con Miss Lucy over here. ¿Verdad? Sería una voz femenina, ¿verdad? Si nos ayudan, por favor. Yep. A feminine voice in here, please. All right, Flor, go ahead, please. Thank you.
Well, I almost always get up very early, at about 5:30. I get up early because I like to go jogging along the beach and watch the sunrise. Later, after breakfast, I go to work. I work in a bank near my home. I then drive to work. I take a bus. It only takes about 20 minutes to get to work. After work, I like to go to my favorite bakery and buy some fresh bread. I get home between 5 o'clock and 5:30. My husband, Michael, usually makes dinner because he loves to cook. In fact, he is a chef in restaurant. His hobby is painting, and my hobby is growing flowers in our garden. We all have a pet dog called Wolfie. In the evening, we take Wolfie for a walk and then get to bed by 9:30 because we have to get up so early again the next morning.
All right, so thank you so much, Flor, over there. Thank you. So now, just to, let's see, give you feedback about this. Now, listen to me, please. If you want, you can take notes. Si gusta, tome notas de la pronunciación. No es que sea la mejor pronunciación, ¿verdad? Pero va a tener como un modelo, all right? So, well, I almost always, esto significa casi siempre, ¿verdad? Si es que quiere decir casi siempre, va a decir almost always. Always es siempre. Sé que este día no nos corresponde estudiar los adverbs of frequency, pero yo no puedo dividir, ¿verdad? Como una cosa de otra, all right? I almost always get up. Les decía, ¿verdad? Get up, la T se hace R. Very early, at about 5:30, I get up early because I like to go jogging along the beach and watch the sunrise, ¿verdad? Later, after breakfast, I go to work. Usted puede decir, I go to work or I go to work fácilmente, ¿ok? Go to work or go to work. I work in a bank. Aquí mire el link sound. I work in a bank near my home. I don't drive to work. I take a bus. Aquí estamos hablando de lo negative statements and positive statements, ¿verdad? En lo de arriba, it was everything positive. Aquí vamos introduciendo los negative statements. I don't drive to work. I take a bus. It only takes, ¿verdad? ¿Cuánto se tarda el bus? It only, right? It only takes. Solamente se tarda. It only takes about 20 minutes to get to work, ¿verdad? Solo se tarda 20 minutos, okay? After work, I like to go to my favorite bakery. I like to go to my favorite bakery and buy some fresh bread. I get home, llego a casa, esto usted lo puede escribir, ¿verdad? Porque son frases bien dadas. I get home, ¿verdad? Llego a la casa, I get home between 5 o'clock and 5:30. Si usted no tiene una hora específica due to the traffic, you can say, entre las 4 o las 4 y media, or 5, you can say, I get home between 5 and 5:30, or I get home between 4:30 and 5, ¿verdad? Entonces, en lugar de decir around, alrededor de o cerca de, usted puede decir between, ¿verdad? Entre las 3 y entre las 4, right? Okay. My husband, Michael, usually, ¿verdad? Como cuando dice shh, shh, para callarse, usually, que es regularmente, eso significa usually, ¿verdad? Regularmente, ¿verdad? Makes dinner because he loves to cook. In fact, remember, in fact significa de hecho, ¿verdad? De hecho. In fact, he's a chef in a restaurant. Otra unión de sonido, right? His hobby is painting, and my hobby is growing flowers in our garden. We also have a pet dog called Wolfie. In the evenings, ¿verdad? Time expression, but son expresiones de tiempo. We take Wolfie for a walk, and then get to bed by 9:30 because we have to get up so early again in the next morning. Okay. All right. So as I said before, right now, let me stop sharing the screen over here. Dejo de compartir. So go practice. Gracias a Dios, tengo una full house right now. And this is the first thing you will be doing right now is to practice. Solo practique, ¿verdad? Take turns. Tome turno. So you're going to be Lucy and then the other gentleman over there, whose name is Mr. Miller. Okay. Solo vamos a leer. All right. So that's what you're going to do right now. So I'm doing the breakout rooms very quickly right now. Okay. Estoy haciendo los salones reducidos en este momento. Here we go. Okay. So please join the breakout rooms if you don't mind. And in this case, usted ya no se llama Flor, ya no se llama Claudia, your name is Lucy now, okay? And your name is no Caesar, your name is Mr. Miller right now. All right, thank you. Susana, le apareció el mensaje para unirse a un salón reducido. Perdón. Sí. ¿Perdón? Le apareció un mensaje para unirse a un salón reducido. Ok, I can see that. Mire qué suerte, qué suerte tienen ustedes, ¿verdad?
¿Verdad?
No, yo digo porque están juntas, ¿verdad? Está ahí, está usted, Claudia. También, ¿verdad? Entonces, los grupos los hago al azar, que conste.
Al azar. ¿Sí? Está bien.
Sí. Vaya, solamente como les tengo confianza, usted dígame. Ahorita en un grupo reducido, bájele. O sea, bájele a cuando habla o hable un poquito más de español. O si ustedes están a gusto, yo me mantengo así. Ok. Entonces, porque de eso se trata. O sea, no los quiero incomodar ni presionarlos demasiado. Porque si ustedes se me pierden, es como que, ¿qué voy a hacer, verdad? Entonces, no quiero que se me procese. Pero creo que vamos poco a poco, ¿verdad? Entonces,
vamos poco a poco, sí. Las diapositivas de todas las clases nos las va a compartir, teacher.
Sí, sí, se la voy a compartir mañana. Las estoy trabajando, no se las quería mandar así, todas arruinadas, entonces. Porque ya he dado este módulo, pero necesito, o sea, cada nivel yo empiezo a ver qué le pongo de más y se me ocurren cosas, entonces por eso, ¿verdad? Pero sí, se lo prometo, mañana se las mando. Sí.
Va, está ahí.
right. Gracias. Well, go ahead, please.
Ok, vaya, entonces vamos a leer y practicar, ¿verdad?
Sí. Si gusta, turnémonos, no sé quién empieza.
¿Se tiene el archivo, Claudia?
Empiezo yo.
Vaya, si gusta.
Sí, lo tengo.
Yeah, but right now, Sarai, take a look at my screen, please. I have it there, so I'm sharing it with you right now.
En el celular.
All right. Yeah.
I am English teacher and I have a big family, so I have a very busy daily routine.
First, usted es Lucy.
Get up.
Uh-huh. You're right, you're right.
Ah, vamos a Lucy. Yeah. Esa ya no. Bye, bye.
Oh. Well,
I am lost always. Hola. Hola.
Ahí sí, lo tiene en la pantalla.
¿Sí me escuchas?
Sí, sí, sí le escuchamos.
Sí, 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 sí.
No, no lo veo.
¿No lo mira? Ok. Saraí, ¿sí lo mira?
Sí, lo miraba. Hoy sí, sí, hoy sí. Sí.
Ok.
Sí. Mira, Claudia.
No lo veo. Alone, the beach,
hola.
And watch the sunrise. ¿Sigo?
Sí.
Hola.
Yeah, continue, please. Thank you.
Hola.
¿Escuchamos, Claudia? Sí, le escuchamos.
Sí, sí, sí.
Ah, vaya. Es que a mí me parece que mi internet está inestable.
Ah, ok.
Lag o later after breakfast I go to work. I work in the bank near my home. I don't drive to work. I take a bus.
Mm-hmm.
It only take about 20 minutes to head to work. After work, I like to walk my favorite bakery and buy some fresh bread. I head home between 5 o'clock and 5:30. My husband, Michael, usually make dinner because he loves to cook.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, mm-hmm. He is chef in restaurant.
Mm-hmm. His hobby.
His hobby is growing.
Mm-hmm.
Growing flowers in our garden. We also have a pet dog. Tal. Wolfie.
Mm-hmm.
We take Wolfie for a walk and the head to bed midnight 30 because
we have to get up so early again. In the next morning. Creo que perdió la señal.
Again.
In next morning, right?
The next morning.
So if you're asking here, or if you're wondering, si usted se pregunta, ¿verdad? ¿Qué significa? Also, le escuchamos, de verdad, Claudia. Thank you. Also significa también. Also. Lo que pasa es que esa palabra puede ir en cualquier lugar. Puede ir antes de comenzar. Ahí en medio, ¿verdad? Como tortilla, como pupusa, o puede ir al final. ¿Verdad? Entonces, ¿verdad? Tenemos, yo puedo decir, also, we have a pet called Wolfie. También tenemos una mascota, ¿verdad?
Also.
Yo le puedo decir, we also, así como está, we also have a pet dog called Wolfie. O también le puedo decir, we have a pet dog called Wolfie also. Pero casi siempre cuando usted quiere agregar algo, enfatizar para decir también, ¿verdad? De una sola vez. Entonces, mi recomendación es o ponerlo antes de todo, also, y eso es lo que yo le recomiendo. Diga, also, also, así como also, como bolsón, ¿verdad? Bolso. Pero diga also, also, como bolso, also. No se le va a olvidar por el bolso, ¿verdad? Que usted anda cargando siempre, ¿verdad? Espero, ¿verdad? Also, así como also, also.
Teacher, una pregunta.
Yes, sir.
La palabra already se puede utilizar de igual forma, al inicio, al final o en medio. Es que medio bueno, cuando...
Muy buena cuando pregunta. Estudié inglés. That's a good question, yes. ¿Y sabe por qué? Porque esos son adverbios. Y un adverbio solo va acompañando la oración, and then it can go at the beginning, in the middle, or at the end. Guardémonos eso, un adverbio, ya sea que sea adverbio de frecuencia, adverbio de tiempo, y todo lo demás que nos han enseñado en lenguaje y literatura. It's basically the same thing. Y also it's an adverb, porque le está diciendo también, ¿verdad? Está agregando más información. Entonces, all right. So I have to go, but please keep on practicing the other one over there. Si quieren practicar, you can take turns, ¿verdad? Cambiamos, you can take Mr. Miller and then you are Miss Lucy, Juan Carlos, etc. All right?
Okay.
Okay.
But right now I have to go. So one second over here. Así bye, que les dejo de compartir and then I'll go here.
Ahorita voy a...
To watch travel shows. Finally, I read and bed for a few minutes before I fall asleep.
Okay. Gentlemen, welcome back.
Hello, teacher.
Hey, teacher.
Hello, sir.
How are you?
I'm good, sir. So how was the 1 week vacation? Cayó bien, ¿verdad?
1 week.
It was good, right?
I fell asleep.
Yeah, you can say
I
fell asleep early, right? You can say that, right? Me quedé dormido, me iba a dormir más temprano. You can say I fell. Si lo quiere ocupar en pasado, solo la cambia una A por una E. Y ya dice I fell asleep. Ayer me dormí en clase, va a decir usted. I fell asleep in class. Don't do it, Mr. Balta. Don't do it, Douglas.
Caí fondeado.
Bien doblado.
Exacto. Okay, so gentlemen, do you have any questions for me about this? All right. Do you have any questions about this? Or not?
Por mi parte, no.
No, all right. So, no questions over there.
Balta or Douglas.
All right.
No.
And you practice already, Lucy and Mr. Miller. Yeah.
Cada uno dijimos lo de Mr. Miller. Ahora cada uno va a decir lo de Lucy.
Okay. That's good, Dovador. Aunque no nos demos cuenta, pero esta práctica ayuda mucho. And little by little, you start, let's say, learning the information of Lucy and Mr. Miller's information, Dovador. Poco a poco se nos queda la información, right? And then you start to make, let's see, like a timeline, ¿verdad? Como una línea de tiempo. That's what you start doing. Yes, yes, sir.
Comentábamos con Mr. Raúl que hay muchas palabras como bien trabadas en este diálogo.
Mencióneme alguna, le echo la mano.
Como egg whites, lunch, and talk soccer.
Mm-hmm. Esto, and I always eat lunch and talk together. Bye.
Ajá.
Esto siempre se va a decir always, ¿verdad? Como la canción,
always.
¿Verdad? De Bon Jovi, ¿verdad? Always. Eat lunch, usted puede decir eat o puede decir have, que es lo mismo. Ok. Have lunch. Acuérdese que talk es una palabra rara, no se pronuncia así como se escribe, va a decir talk. La L no existe, la A no existe, solo dice talk. Talk.
Talk together.
Talk together. 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 Okay. Together. Trate de decirlo de corrido, ¿verdad? Entonces respetemos los signos de puntuación. The other teachers and I always eat lunch and talk together. in the teacher's room, ¿verdad? Se ponen a chambrear, ¿verdad? All right. Okay, etcétera, etcétera. Over there. Lo ideal es comenzar a utilizar los signos de puntuación, así como en español, ¿verdad? Then, I do some exercise, eat dinner with my family, and watch TV before I go to bed at about 10 o'clock. Entonces, wow, hay que agarrar aire, Mr. Balta.
Okay.
O sea, usted no lo va a decir así tan rápido, right? But you can do it like, then...
Vamos a ir despacio.
Then I do some exercise, comma... Then, así como cuando el chavo le dictaba a Don Ramón, vea, o viceversa. Coma.
La tía Beba.
Exactly. Then I do exercise, eat dinner with my family, and watch TV before I go to bed.
I go to bed.
At about 10 o'clock. Punto seguido. We love to watch travel shows. Me gusta ver Discovery Channel, vea. Finally, I read in bed for a few minutes before I fall asleep. Esto es una gran práctica, leer aunque sea en
el teléfono,
or with a book. That's a great practice. All right. Okay, that's something that we should do. All right, continue, please, gentlemen.
Thank you, Chief.
Welcome, sir. See you around. Maybe two more minutes, and then we will come back. All right.
Okay. Okay.
But okay, Mr. Lucy.
Hello.
Teacher.
Hello. Good to
see you. Teacher, what's the meaning of growing flower?
Oh, okay. Let me ask you. Hold on. Le voy a contestar haciéndole preguntas. Okay. All right.
Do no you me have parece, a garden? Pero bueno.
Okay. Ni modo, ¿verdad? Anyway. Ni modo. Anyway. So, do you have a garden? Do you have a garden, Rocío? A garden.
Yes, I have.
Do you like roses? Roses,
yes.
Or any type of flower? Yeah, it's like if you plant, let's say, I don't know, a flower, it gets bigger because it grows. So mm-hmm. Growing flowers. Like for example, I have one son, but I tengo un hijo, and then right now he is 3 years and a half, and he's growing every single day. He's growing, and then he will be a teenager and then an adult. Crecer.
Okay. Es como me gusta sentarme a ver las flores crecer o algo así, no sé, o a tomar el aire en el jardín.
Okay. De hecho, continuamos desde aquí, mira, dice, his hobby is painting, o sea, el hobby o el pasatiempo es pintar, y mi pasatiempo es sembrar flores, por ejemplo, ese es el contexto, growing flowers.
Ok, thank
sembrar
you.
Flores, yes, in our garden. Let me ask you in general, Susana and Mr. Oscar, good to see you over there, sir. What's the meaning of also? What is the meaning of also, by the way? Without using Google Translator, please. All right, yet. Todavía no. Not yet. All right, also.
Also?
What if I tell you a synonym?
Let's do
a
synonym. Teacher, what is also?
Ahorita. Le doy un sinónimo, okay?
¿Ok?
Two. T-O-O. Two. T-O-O.
Two.
What's the meaning of two? T-O-O, Miss Pimentel.
También.
Exactly. So also means two.
Okay.
But also is used at the beginning of a sentence or in the middle. And two is used in the end. All right?
Okay. Repeat, please. Also,
yes. Also, at the beginning and the middle of a sentence. All right? And two, at the end. Y aquí es como el jabón Protex, ¿verdad? 99%, ¿verdad? Efectivo. ¿Verdad? Les digo eso porque hay excepciones. ¿verdad? Entonces, there are some exceptions over there. All right. So I can tell you, in the morning, I let's see, send some emails. Segunda oración. Also, I have meetings with parents, and that's me, right? That's me, my daily routine over there. Okay, I send some emails, you know, to some parents. I send reports. I teach classes, and also, okay, o puede decir also, I have meetings with parents. Podría decir lo mismo. Okay, I send email reports, and I have meetings with parents too. Okay, just like that, and that is the difference. El also le sirve mucho para enfatizar y para que usted tenga tiempo de pensar lo que va a decir. Okay. All right. Nice. Let's go back to the main section. If you don't have a question for me, any other question for me? Or do you have another question for me or not? All right. So let's go back.
Yeah.
Thank you. One second. All right, so thank you. Welcome back, everyone. Let's see, do we have everyone over here? No, I only have 7 right now. Okay, so now you have the opportunity to practice this and get to know a little bit about Mr. Miller, who is a teacher, and then he has 3 children, Matthew, John, and Susie. And you know Mr. Miller's daily routine. O sea, ya sabemos la rutina diaria de este señor. Okay. Also, you have the opportunity to practice the daily routine, Mrs. Lucy daily routine. Okay. She takes a bus. She doesn't drive. For example, she likes pan dulce, right? She likes pan dulce. Le gusta el pan dulce. Maybe she's Salvadoran, right? Quizás es salvadoreña. Semita, right? That's why it says over here. Yo esperaba que alguien me dijera esto. Take a look at this. It says, after work, solo le falta que diga que es a las 4 de la tarde, ¿verdad? O en cafecito de la tarde. It says, after work, I like to go to my favorite bakery and buy some fresh bread. ¿Verdad? Panadería, bakery. All right? And buy some fresh bread in there. Usted puede decir sweet, como dulce, sweet bread, para enfatizar que es pan dulce, right? Okay. So you have 2 different people in there, right? 2 different people. One is a teacher who works maybe at a public school or at a private school. Por eso les mencioné, ¿verdad? What's the difference? ¿Cuál es la diferencia entre una escuela pública y un colegio, ¿verdad? Entonces, no diferencia estructural, ¿verdad? Sino que en concepto, ¿verdad? En significado, of the words. Okay. And she also talks about her husband and everything. So her husband makes dinner because he's a chef. Acuérdense que para decir cocinero, para decir también chef, usted puede decir como el verbo cook, cocinar, cook. ¿Verdad? Cook. ¿Verdad? C-O-O-K. Cook. All right. Now, this is what you will be working on right now. One will be the interviewer, and the other one will be Mr. Miller. Okay? And this is what you will be doing right now in the breaker room. In the breaker room over there. For example, imagine... just imagine over here. Imagine Mr. Nelson Hernandez. Good to see you, sir, by the way. All right? Good to see you over there, sir, Mr. Nelson. Imagine that you practice, you are Mr. Mueller. So, and then in the breakout room, you are practicing with, let's see who's over here. So imagine that you're practicing with Miss Susana, right? Portillo. Imagine that you're practicing together. So since you, Mr. Nelson, you are Mr. Mueller, Susana will ask you the question. So what jobs does Mr. Mueller have? Is he a busy person? Busy person. And then, no tiene que memorizar nada, right? You don't have to memorize anything. Then you have to look at the information over there and see the type of job that he has. So you can say, Mr. Mueller is a teacher, all right? He works at a school, et cetera, et cetera. All right, but he has like one or two jobs in there. Entonces, esta vez vamos a leer for comprehension purposes, okay? Right now you will read for comprehension purposes over there, okay? Do we have an agreement, everyone? Yeah, thank you, sir. You're doing this, the thumbs up. And then, for example, let's see that Miss Pimentel is Lucy, and then you are practicing with Cesar, for example. Cesar will ask you this question. We'll ask you the questions, why does Miss Lucy get up very early every morning? Y como les dije que esto iba a ser de una forma, ¿verdad? Deductiva, all right? So you have to look for the information and answer, okay? Answer over there. En este lugar van a contestar en tercera persona. No van a decir, I work at a school, ¿verdad? No van a decir, I work at a bank. Usted va a decir, she works at a bank, he is a teacher, etcétera, etcétera. Va a hablar en tercera persona, okay? Remember, ya sea que nos acordemos cómo hablar en tercera persona o no, we're going to review this later on. Ya lo vamos a reforzar un poquito. Lo importante es communication right now. ¿Cuál es el énfasis? Right now, it's communication, okay? Let's do some practicing here, and I'm going to be choosing may I ask for a volunteer, please? I'm going to ask you just one single question. Solo una pregunta le voy a hacer, all right? You can take notes, you can write the answers down, you can have your cell phone, ¿verdad? No es un examen de rapidez ni nada de eso. You just have to look for the information. Okay, aquí está. Bye. Mr. Mueller is a teacher. He works in the morning, in the afternoon, at 4 o'clock, etc. ¿Verdad? Entonces, utilicemos las time expressions. No importa si nos tardamos, hay que tener paciencia con su compañero. So, may I please have one volunteer, please, que me ayude solamente a... Maybe you can ask me the questions right now. Hágame dos preguntas. And I'm going to give you a demonstration. So usted va a ser el entrevistador right now. Okay? Feminine or masculine right now? It doesn't really matter. Yo voy a ser Mr. Mueller right now. Okay? Un volunteer, please. Can I have a volunteer? Please. Yeah, I can see. Yeah. Miss Pimentel, right? Thank you. All right. Yeah. You get to choose right now. All right. You can ask me the first questions or the last questions or whatever. So it's up to you. Go ahead, please.
Okay. What time does Mr. Mueller get up every morning?
Okay. All right. So he gets up at 6 o'clock every day. All right. Just like that. Okay.
Okay.
And then you can continue. All right. You can continue. Ask me. What's the second question over there? Proceed. I have it here. Take a look at my screen.
Number four.
Okay.
What does he do after what does he do after he helps his kids with their homework?
Okay.
What does
okay, with his kids after the homework. And here we go. What I do is I scan very quickly the information of the homework over here. In the afternoon, I grade my students. After I get back, I help my kids with the homework. I have 3 kids in elementary names or. And since I'm not a walking encyclopedia, honestamente, en lo que estaba buscando la información, se me olvida la pregunta. I go back. Okay, so I go back and look for the answer over there. So what does he do after he helps his kids with his homework? Okay, el énfasis says after helping his kids with the homework over here. All right, and then okay, after. Yo puedo retomar su pregunta, Rocío. So I can use your question, you know, to introduce my answer. O solamente le respondo directamente. Okay? It doesn't really matter. So I go straight to the point. Voy directo al grano. He does some exercise. It's dinner with his family and watches TV before he goes to bed at about 10 o'clock. Okay? As you can see, I conjugate the verbs. He conjugado los verbos. O yo puedo comenzar retomando la parte de la pregunta que usted me hizo. Ok, take a look. Usted me dice, what does he do after he helps his kids with their homework? Ok, después de ayudarle a sus niños, ¿qué es lo que hace? All right. And then I have the information over here and it says, take a look at this. It says, after I get back home, I help my kids with their homework. I have 3 kids. Aquí solo está dando información, ¿verdad? Les ayudo, tengo 3 niños, ¿verdad? Los tengo en primaria, etcétera, etcétera. Estos son los nombres, etcétera, ¿verdad? Y me disculpo si les estoy traduciendo, ¿verdad? Pero quiero que quede esto un poquito más claro. Y luego dice, then, después, ok, then, después de ayudarles y de haber mencionado, ponerles el contexto de que tengo 3 niños y se llaman de esta forma, luego hago lo siguiente, then I do some exercise, eat dinner with my family and watch TV before I go to bed at about 10 o'clock. This part, before I go to bed at about 10 o'clock, I would say that it's additional information, ¿verdad? Es información adicional que no va directamente relacionada con la pregunta que usted me hizo, right, Rocío? Because what matters is only he works out o hace ejercicio, it's dinner with his family, ¿verdad? Pongámosle cuidado, ¿verdad? Possessive adjectives. Si usted dice, por ejemplo, my, his, her, their, and our, those are possessive, ¿verdad? The I is my. Okay, you, your, all right? He, his, etc., etc. Those are the things that you have to remember over there. Okay? Yep. Now, let's go to practice over there. Okay, let's go to practice over there. Of course, my friends, right now you will practice with somebody else. Van a practicar con compañeros distintos, all right? So this is the opportunity over there. Let me just 1 second over here. 1 moment, please. Para que esto funcione, tengo que ver cuántos están para poder asignarlos de una forma equitativa. Over here. So that's what we have. Here we go. All right. There you go. So please join the breakout rooms in there and ask questions. Pueden hacer 1, 2, or questions at a 1 single shot in there, okay? Hello, Anayansi. ¿Cómo le va? How are you? Mr. Nelson, hello, sir.
Hello,
hello, Ana.
Hola.
And then we have Miss Zulma Gonzalez. Okay. Prefiere que le llame Zulma, Zulma o Marlene o Mrs. Gonzalez.
No, está bien, Zulma.
Hello, Zulma.
Hi. Hi,
Nana.
And Nelson.
Hola, Nana.
Sí, esta no es de ella. O sea, es suya.
Por Dios.
All right, so I don't know. Maybe would you like to start, Mr. Hernandez Nelson? Would you like to start, sir?
Okay.
So in that case, you can interview, o sea, puede entrevistar a Nayansi and Zulma. Maybe you can go one question, you know, for Nayansi and one question for Zulma over there about Lucy, right? It's up to you. Remember, Mr. Nelson, that you have the PDF in your cell phone. If you have maybe your cell phone, you can do it that way. But with me, hágame la demostración solamente en una pregunta, si no le molesta, por favor.
Sí. Ok, Miss Anayansi.
Ok.
Why does Miss Lucy get up very early every morning?
No la encuentro todavía. In the morning.
That's okay. Keep on looking. You know, keep on looking. Siga buscando, ¿verdad? Y también lo que podemos hacer, si nos tardamos, your classmate, all right, can help you, ¿verdad? Le ayudamos y le decimos, mire, está después de tal palabra, ¿verdad? And you help each other over there. Right, you can do that.
Thank
you. Did you find it, Miss Anayansi? Did you find it? No. Okay. Remember, y podemos también apoyarnos. So you can help each other, repitiendo la pregunta, si les parece, ¿verdad? Why?
Yeah.
Y así practicamos, ¿verdad? La cuestión es, you know, to have the interaction over there. So you should have the interaction over there.
No sé si gusta, Mr. La pantalla.
Creo que ya la encontré.
Ok.
De ahora. De real. At about 5 years.
Yes, you're right. But the question is, ¿por qué se levanta tan temprano? Why? Okay, why? No solamente el hecho de qué es lo que hace. Okay, the time. So why?
I get up.
Yeah, you're right. Y perdón que le interrumpa. En este caso, usted me va a decir la niña Lucy. Right? You're going to tell me that. So,
she is up early because I like to go. No sé cómo se dice. Jogging.
Jogging.
Jogging along the beach and watch the sunrise.
Yeah, you got it. You can say, she gets up early because she likes to go jogging along the beach and watch the sunrise. El único verbo que va a cambiar es el likes. Yeah.
Like.
Yeah, she gets up early because she likes to go jogging. Le gusta ir a trotar. Y a mirar el amanecer. All right?
Jogging along the beach.
Okay. That's what you're saying. So continue with her, please. Pay attention to what is being asked to you. Poner atención, ¿qué le están preguntando? If it's where, es el lugar, right? Where, ¿dónde? If it's how long, ¿por cuánto tiempo? Right? What, el qué, right? O el cual. And what kinds, ¿qué tipos? O ¿qué especies? Okay? What kinds? Who? It's the person, right? And what time? Of course, is the time, or the hour, and etc. etc. All right.
Okay.
Nice. So I gotta go. So see you around. Alguien más puede compartir la pantalla. In general, I don't know. Maybe Miss Gonzalez, Zuma, or somebody else. You tell me.
No, yo no tengo la pantalla, no sé si alguien pudiera compartirla.
Compartir pantalla.
Porque si no, me tendría que salir de la sala para irme a WhatsApp.
Nelson, ¿puede compartir usted por casualidad? O si no, nos pasamos en el celular solamente, ¿verdad? En su aparato. ¿En general?
No puedo porque yo con una tablet estoy.
Ah, ok. That's okay. Entonces, en ese caso, como la vieja escuela, como que tuviéramos un libro, hacen la pregunta. And then you just answer with your cell phone, right?
Entonces me voy para WhatsApp yo y si me preguntan, si, o sea, si no me ven ahí en la cámara, estoy en WhatsApp, pero sí los escucho.
Con el ok, entonces hay que buscar el PDF.
Pero ahí,
ok.
Uh-huh. Ok, ok.
Bueno, ya estoy ahí. No sé si van a hacer preguntas.
Hello, teacher.
Hello again, sir.
Hi, teacher.
No, you cannot run away from me, right? No puede escapar. You know, that's a good technique, what you're doing right now, right? Maybe you're looking for the answers. Está buscando la información and then you're just writing it down. Esa es una buena práctica, right? That's a good practice.
Yes.
But right now, since I just want to see that you're actually doing something, ¿verdad? Porque me interesa mucho que usted practique speaking, okay. ¿Verdad? Speaking, which is cuando habla. I don't know, maybe Douglas. Quiero conocer su voz, ¿verdad? Es broma.
Ya le puse no, nervioso, Tich.
¿Verdad? Douglas, could you ask, I don't know, maybe Susana, Miss Portillo, one question. Yo les comparto la pantalla, all right?
Okay.
Let me share the screen over there. Now, please, be careful. Pongamos atención si nos preguntan el qué, cómo, cuándo y dónde, ¿verdad? Así como cuando usted llega a su casa, ¿verdad? ¿Dónde estuviste? ¿Con quién? Así, ¿verdad? Entonces, ese mismo interés. Okay. All right, so, Douglas, you can ask question number 1, 2, 3, and 4, or 5. Si usted gusta, you go in order, o va en desorden, como usted gusta.
Ok. Number 1. Why does Miss Lucy get up very early every morning?
All right. So in this case, I'm gonna ask you, Susana, why? What is the meaning of why? Why? In Spanish.
¿Qué?
Why es el por qué?
Why el por qué?
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Let's pay attention to that. And aunque no lo estamos preguntando ahorita, ¿verdad, Mr. Baltazar? Mm-hmm. Vamos a buscar la respuesta and see if you can actually find it. Over there, right?
Okay.
In that way, you're going to help us. Para comenzar, hay que encontrar el párrafo correcto, ¿verdad? Mm-hmm. Me estaba equivocando yo en una práctica anterior. All right, so this is Miss Lucy.
Okay? Lucy.
Mm-hmm. And the question is, okay, la pregunta es, why does Lucy get up very early every morning? ¿Por qué se levanta tempranito esta muchacha?
Okay. Because she's going along the beach and watch the sunrise.
Yeah, that's actually perfect. Yeah, that's actually perfect. You can say because she likes or because she goes going along the beach and watches the sunrise. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's actually good.
Or that's she's working a bank.
Yeah, you can say, yeah, you can say that, but I would say it is that very early, o sea, más de lo normal, más temprano, because she goes jogging, and then she gets ready to go to work, right?
Okay.
That's what I think, all right?
Okay.
Okay, thank you, and that's what you're going to do. So maybe, Douglas, you continue asking Susana the other questions over there, please, if you don't mind. Okay, thank you. So I gotta go over here. So maybe I don't know if you, Mr. Baltazar, or if you, Susana, can share the screen. I think that's easier. Otherwise, you have to use the cell phone mindor, right? Si no pueden compartir, use the cell phone.
Estamos nada más como no podemos compartir pantalla, pero estamos en el teléfono.
Okay, okay, that's okay.
Okay, continue.
Because she likes to go jogging along the beach and watch the sunrise. Vamos a ver la segunda. Where does Miss Lucy work? Ah, terminó. No. Where does Miss Lucy work? Thanks.
She work in a bank.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's it, right, Juan Carlos? Yeah, how that's long, it. Right?
How long does it take Miss Lucy to get to work?
Over here, Eduardo. So take a look at my screen, please. I'm sharing it with you. It's over here.
Oh, sorry, I watched you. Okay. About, let me see. What's the answer? How long does it take Miss Lucy to get to work? Oh, okay. Only minutes?
Yeah, you can say only 20 minutes. You can say that. Yeah, that's okay. Or you can say 20 minutes only, right? Just like that, right? Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah. The next one is, what is Miss Lucy's hobby?
Growing flowers in her garden.
Correct. Yeah, correct. And yes.
What does Miss Lucy do in the evenings?
She takes golf before I walk.
And yeah, you can say that. Yeah, that's the only team over there. Correct. Yeah, that's basically it. So did you finish both Mr. Miller and Miss Lucy questions over there?
Two times. I made it two times.
Yeah, so that was actually fast for you. Now let's do something over there. So go below and then you have... then you have the answer. So in the same document, all right? In there, you can double check if your answers are correct or not, okay? But you can do it later because we don't really have the time. So we need to continue with the class right now, okay? So let's go back to the main session, everyone.
Okay, thanks.
All right. All right, so we're going to wait just a couple of seconds before we continue with the class over here. All right, so bear with me just one moment in there. Okay. All right, so welcome back, everyone. Let's continue with this. And let me just, let's say, share with you the secret of this activity. All right, so let me just share the screen very quickly. And here we go. So let me just 1 second, please. So lo pongo en silencio. I'm just gonna mute your microphone and then we take it from there. All right. All right, so there we go. All right, please take a look at my screen. I think now everyone is familiar with Mr. Miller's daily routine and then Miss Lucy's daily routine. One is a teacher, the other one works at a bank. Maybe she's a cashier or a front desk assistant or something like that. Or a financial analyst. Okay, so in total, you have 5 questions to ask about Mr. Miller and then 5 questions about Miss Lucy, all right? For example, questions like, what job does Mr. Miller have? Is he a busy person? What time does Mr. Miller get up every morning? Questions like, what is Miss Lucy's hobby, et cetera, et cetera. Now, I'm going to ask you I'm going to ask you, let's see, some of these questions. Let's see, and then you're supposed to answer. Let's see very quick, Linda. Okay? So, and right now, I'm going to ask you, Cesar, if you don't mind, please, Cesar, about Mr. Miller, sir. Who does Mr. Miller have lunch with?
He has lunch with other teacher.
With other teachers, right? Well, yeah, with co-workers, you can say. Now, in this case, thank you, sir. You have two options. You can give me a complete answer or a short answer. So in this case, you gave me a complete answer, like the complete sentence, right? You told me he has lunch with other teachers. You just can tell me with other teachers. Okay. So in real life, you just can answer to me what I'm asking. ¿Qué le estoy preguntando? ¿Con quién? So you just can answer me, okay, with other teachers. All right? Okay, in this case, you can do this, right? Because we're talking about people. But Cesar, so what if I ask you, what does he do after helping his kids with their homework? In that case, you have to tell me the actions because I'm asking you what, right? So could you help me, please, Cesar? So what does he do after he helps his kids with the homework?
He does some exercise.
Correct. And you can also say he works out. Works out. Trabajar y luego la preposición out, de afuera, right? Eso significa hacer ejercicio, right? Work out, work out. In this case, you say he works out or he exercises. There are three options, all right? You have three options. Para hacer ejercicio, usted puede decir, he exercises, he works out, or he does exercises. Three options, okay?
Sin la palabra some.
Ahorita lo vamos en el WhatsApp le escribo. He works out. He exercises. All right. Ahí ya le cayó la notificación. Or he does exercises. Okay. Miremos el WhatsApp, por favor. En la primera que es, works out. El énfasis es hacer ejercicio, right? Works out significa hacer ejercicio. He exercises is the same thing. And he does exercises es lo mismo, ¿verdad? And then you have three options now how to say hacer ejercicio. In the United States, people say, I work out at the gym three times a week, etc., etc. All right? So that's what you do. Now, I'm going to ask two more questions to a lady that can actually help us over here. Okay, so I'm going to stop sharing the screen and I'm gonna take a look at this. If you don't mind, Susana, please, Ms. Portillo, help us with two answers for Lucy, please, very quickly over here. Okay, and here we go. How long does it take Miss Lucy to get to work? How long does it take Miss Lucy to get to work? Miss Susana, por ti. All right, let's see. Susana, su micrófono. There you go.
Number right. question three?
I think so. Yeah, it's question three.
Oh, two. Yeah, question three. Yes. It takes here about 20 minutes.
All right. So in this case, yeah, you just can answer me straightforward, right? You can tell me 20 minutes. Just like that. Okay. Or you can tell me around 20 minutes or it takes about 20 minutes or a complete answer. It only takes about 20 minutes.
Okay.
So it's up to you. So you decide, brother. So another question for you, Miss Portillo. Okay. So okay. Help me with the following. What does she do in the evenings, please? What does she do in the evening? Question number five. All right. Question number five.
Take her dog for a walk.
Yeah, correct. You can say taking the dog for a walk, or she takes the dog for a walk. Now, if it's an action, it's always, always, always mandatory to use a subject. En inglés no podemos omitir los sujetos, okay?
Okay.
Y se puede cuando ya ha mencionado una vez la persona, okay? For example, in this case, you have to say, she takes the dog for a walk, all right? She takes the dog for a walk, all right?
Okay.
Okay, she takes the dog for a walk, however. Okay. En español sí decimos, ¿verdad? Saca a pasear al perro o a la mascota y va implícito, ¿verdad? El sujeto. But in English, you have to actually say it, ¿verdad? Okay. Nice. So we're done with this. Remember, we covered. ¿Qué cubrimos con esta conversación sin que yo les explicara la gramática? So we covered simple present. WH questions over there, like what, how, what time, when. No, we didn't cover when. Well, we covered why and where. Cubrimos los más principales. What, who, why, where. Okay. El cómo, cuándo, dónde, y por qué. I think we covered that. All right. With Mr. Miller and with Miss Lucy Information Mother. Un mago quizás no revela sus secretos, right? But right now I'm going to rebuild this. I mean, I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to tell you my secrets. As you can see in there, you have the answer in there, okay? The answers for Miss Lucy and for Mr. Miller. If you were able to answer this, like similar, like this, like for example, Cesar, you told me, he does exercise, it's dinner and watches TV, which is okay. You told me he does exercise, that's okay. And then, like right now, Susana, I just asked you how long does it take Lucy to get to work? Get to significa llegar a un lugar, okay? About 20 minutes. So as you can see, ¿por qué está en paréntesis? Porque esa información usted la puede omitir, all right? So you can skip it. That's why it's in parentheses. Eso les decía, ¿verdad? Short answer or a long answer. Y esa es la maravilla del inglés. Igual que en español, usted puede omitir de repente la frase. En este caso, si usted solamente me dice la frase, solo me va a decir la frase, growing flowers, ¿ok? Y en este caso, si usted me va a omitir el sujeto, pero tiene que decirme toda la frase, aunque no es recomendable, ¿verdad? She takes her dog for a walk, ok, takes her dog for a walk, alright? Entonces, ahorita le digo, no me omita el sujeto, porque estamos aprendiendo y para que después usted decida omitirlo o no. All right? Pero yo le digo que 99% de las veces el sujeto en inglés tiene que ir. All right? Cuando usted no ha mencionado la persona que hace la acción, el sujeto es obligatorio. Solo cuando usted ya se refiere y todos saben que estamos hablando de Lucy y de Mr. Miller, usted sí ya puede omitir el sujeto y se ubica solamente en la acción. ¿Ok?
Ok.
Esa es la regla. So that's the rule over there. Okay. Nice. I would say just to close this, we will do something different, Miller. So si me permiten, por cuestiones de control de asistencia, voy a solamente mencionar sus nombres. Si no menciono, if I don't mention your names, you just tell me, Jose, you didn't mention my name over here. Okay. Comienzo con lo que tengo aquí presente. So I have you, Miss Susana, Anayansi, Mr. Baltasar, Cesar. Let me just one second. Let me make this bigger. Okay. Comienzo. Voy a mencionar solamente sus primer nombre y un apellido. Okay. Susana Portillo, Anayansi Rodríguez, Baltasar González, Cesar Rivera, Claudia Enríquez, y lo menciona así, ¿verdad? Por cuestiones de lista, para que así corrijamos si hay un error, que su nombre está mal, su apellido está mal, ¿verdad? Mal reportado. Ok, Dolores Saraí Molina, Claudia Enríquez, Douglas Vázquez, Eduardo Ernesto, I'm sorry, Eduardo Hernández, Efraín Antonio Alas, Flor Sánchez, Francisco Rodríguez, Juan Carlos Alas, Catherine García, Nelson Hernández, Oscar Melara, Raúl Meléndez, Rocío Pimentel, Zulma González. Ok. Se me olvidó algún nombre, me salté algún nombre, ustedes me dicen, lo corrijo en este momento, permítanme. Solo necesito, ok, registrar algo por acá. And then, one second, over. So, did I mention everyone over here? Yes. Everybody is included, right? A todos los mencioné. I can say that, right? All right. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Okay. Okay, so let's take a look at the another exercise that I have for you over here. But right now, it'll be something different. Okay. Right now, we will practice a conversation in there, right? Los que tuvieron prácticas conmigo el mes pasado, so we practiced last month, and then you know that I like to share with you conversations and everything over there, right? So that's what I like to do in there. Okay. But before, before the class is over, all right, let me just not to assign extra homework to you, como ustedes saben, las únicas tareas obligatorias que cuentan para cuestiones de aprobación son lo que está en la plataforma, ¿verdad? Son las únicas. But for tomorrow, at least, I want you to think about the following. Think about your daily routine during either weekdays or over the weekend. But think about one day in which you are very active. So in other words, your homework for tomorrow will be to think or maybe to write about your daily routine. Okay, pensemos en lo siguiente. Significa que tomorrow at 8 o'clock, the first thing we will practice is daily routine. Okay, your job is to share your information about your daily routine. Piense en el día que usted está más ocupado, or the most busy day that you have during the week. Maybe it's a Monday, maybe it's a Friday, maybe it's a Saturday, or maybe think of the last day of the month. When you do an inventory, piense en el día que hace inventario. Think about these days in which you have to complete a payroll, cuando tiene que hacer, ¿verdad?, la planilla, or you have to send a lot of reports. But in your case, Raúl, that you have to do a lot of paperwork, right? Entonces, think about that, right? So I'm not asking you to send anything to me, but if you want to send something to me, si usted, no sé, en su hora de almuerzo se puede escribir y usted dice, okay, in the morning, I do this. In the afternoon, I do the following. And in the evening, I do the following. And this happens on Monday. You can use adverbs of frequency, etc. Remember, esto no es obligación, pero se los dejo solamente para que practiquemos y pongamos lo que hemos visto hoy en práctica, ¿verdad? Valga la redundancia. Why? Because in that way, you will be ready to share your information with your classmates. Y de hoy en adelante nos vamos a volver secretaries, ¿verdad? Vamos a tomar notas de sus compañeros, porque yo les voy a preguntar, okay, now, Oscar, tell me, imagine that you practice with Eduardo. So tell me Eduardo's routine at the end of the month. You know, when things are crazy, you know, you're very busy, right? Like up and down in there, right? Or I can ask you, so Eduardo, tell me about Sarai's daily routine in her busiest day, ¿verdad? En el día más apurado, right? Et cetera, et cetera. So that will be the practice for tomorrow. All right? Yes? Nice. si usted quiere que yo le pegue una revisadita a lo que usted dice y le digo, ok, do the following, o le digo, everything is perfect, si me confía, ok, send it to me, and I'm going to help you. O sea, yo esto es lo que hago, mañana, tarde, so that's what I do. Como les comentaba, en el día yo trabajo con estudiantes de bachillerato, ¿verdad? In a private school, y toca revisar un montón de cosas with parents and everything. So I'm a full-time teacher, all right? So that's what I do. And literally, soy un full-time teacher, ¿verdad? Soy a tiempo completo. Even at night. Todavía no hemos terminado, ¿verdad? Nuestra labor for today. So give me just a couple of seconds, please, while I send this information over. Okay? While I send this information to you right now. Bear with me just one. Yes. Okay. Solo para ir cerrando, no le voy a poner a completar ninguna información. Ahorita solo vamos a hacer una práctica just pronunciation over. Si gusta, levántese, you know, get up, get some water, like the one I have over here. Este es el momento para que usted me hace una pregunta o algo, algo general del módulo, si es que lo tiene, ¿verdad? O algo que quiera compartir, etcétera, etcétera. No estoy viendo las pantallas, entonces si va a hablar algo, le pido que abra su micrófono, ¿verdad? Entonces así los puedo escuchar. Ok. No questions, no further participation over here. We're good? Yep.
Teacher.
Yes.
Dijo que cada día que hiciéramos la tarea en el manual, lo compartiéramos en el WhatsApp. ¿Así es?
Gracias por la pregunta. El día viernes, cuando ya tenga completada la primera, el primer set de la primera tarea. La primera tarea se divide en 5 actividades. Entonces, cuando complete la unidad 1 o la section 1, ahí ya me manda ya sea la gráfica de barras o me presenta el porcentaje que diga 100%, 80%, 90%. ¿Verdad?
Ok.
Just one complete thing over there. All right, so that's what I'm asking me there. Okay, so right now, let me go ahead and share with you the following, my friends, over here. Okay, remember that if I'm sharing with you material which is copyrighted, if you share the screen, please be careful, como me recordó Mr. Rivera, erase la URL, ¿verdad? O la dirección, ¿verdad? Del lugar que le estoy mandando. Entonces, this is the last thing you're going to practice right now. And I'm just sending this to the WhatsApp. And if you're not in WhatsApp, I'm going to send this to the chat over here on Zoom. All right? So that's okay. Since it's a conversation, todavía tenemos como 2 minutos o algo, más o menos, you know, more or less over there. Let me go ahead and share this with you right now. Okay. Obviously, I'll be playing this with you just for you to listen to the pronunciation over there. Once you listen to this, I'm going to send you to the breakout rooms to practice. Escuchemos la pronunciación, les comparto pantalla, take notes and everything. This is going to be simple. It's just a review. And then once everyone is familiar with this, los mando a practicar, all right? One last practice of the evening over there. Okay. Here we go.
Conversation number 1. What do you do?
I work at a tech company.
Oh, what do you do there?
I design software.
Do you like your job?
Yeah, I enjoy it.
Conversation 2. Do you work here?
Yes, I do.
Where do I pay my bill?
You pay it over there.
Do I need to show ID?
I don't think you do.
What do your parents do?
They both work in sales.
Oh, what do they sell?
They both sell cars. They have a car dealership together.
Do they like it?
Yes, but they work long hours.
Conversation 4. Where do you live?
I live downtown with my family.
Nice. Do you live in an apartment or house?
I live in a house, but we need more space.
Do you want to move?
Yes, we want to move to the countryside.
All right, so you were able to listen, right? Sí, sí, se escuchó la conversación, perdón. Yep. Okay, yeah. Thank you. So now, as you can see, this is just practice, okay? This is just practice. So you have four short conversations. What do you do? Do you, yes, no questions, like, do you work in here? What do your parents do? Where do you live, etc. So right now, that's what you're going to do, right? So let's practice for 2 minutes, and then let's come back, and then we say goodbye, all right? So that's what we do right now. So I'm doing the breakout rooms right now very quickly as I'm speaking. Here we go. All right, so please go ahead and join the rooms, everyone. Thank you.
Ok, será compartir. Tres quizás seremos.
Sí, pero quiero compartir pantalla, permítame un segundo.
Gracias, gracias siempre por su ayuda.
Ahí estamos, a la orden. Ok. Permítame que no puedo bajar esto. Logran visualizar.
Sí. Yes, exactly. Just like that. Thank you.
Vaya, empecemos.
Ok. Así, línea por
empiezo
línea.
Yo.
Lleguemos.
Cabal. Eso vamos. Si quiere, empiezo yo, no sé con quién de ustedes, y luego en la conversación 2, ya otra persona.
Ok.
Vaya. What do you do?
I work at a tech company.
Oh, what do you do there?
I design software.
Do you like your job?
Yeah, I enjoy it.
Yes, tech company, tech. La CH es una K.
Tech. Tech company. Ok, gracias.
Tech company. Una K bien chiquita porque usted está diciendo tech company. El mismo sonido. Tech company. Ok, continúe, pues.
Ahora, no sé, alguien más.
Ok, voy.
Hoy hacemos la otra, ¿verdad, Flor? Where do you live?
I live downtown with my family.
Nice. Do you live in a in an apartment or house?
I live in a house, but we need more space.
Do you want to move?
Yes, we want to move to the countryside.
All right. So thank you, Flor. It's live, right? I live in a house. Live, right? Live.
Okay.
Nice. Did you finish like practicing everyone, Francisco?
Yeah, we did.
All right, thank you. So in that case, you just got the right to go to sleep. Okay.
Thanks.
Okay. Nice. Thank so
you tomorrow, teacher.
Yeah, you may leave right now, or we go back to the main room, but you can leave already, okay? That's okay. So see you tomorrow.
Okay.
See you tomorrow, teacher.
See you tomorrow, Flo. All right, so welcome back, everyone. We will stop the class over here. As you can see, these conversations are pretty simple, maybe not too basic, but it just helps you practice questions and then quick responses, ¿verdad? Respuestas bien precisas, all right? So thank you for joining the class this evening and hope to see you tomorrow, all right? We have a full house in the first, class, ¿verdad? Hemos comenzado bien. Okay, we studied just fine over here. So good to see you, everyone, and nice to meet you, Susana, Zulma, Francisco, and then the rest over there, please. So see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye. Bye, sir.
Good night.
See you.
Good night.
Good night, class.
Good night, teacher.
Good night, Mr. Balta.